only freedom. It means you have to let other people be free, even if they disagree with you. I had a tremendous admiration for the courage of those two communists who had the guts to walk up with their little communist sign and their communist flag. Two of them, young people, all alone, in that sea of America, militia, uniformed patriots. And I saw people who wanted to kill them. You know, I don't like their philosophy. They're misled, misguided. Communism is a terrible thing. But they had guts. I had a great respect for them. And I believe in freedom. Which means there is no way in the world that we could have had that meeting on your state house grounds this morning unless they had the right to do what they did. Then you had better understand that. Because if you stop them from having their freedom to make their political statement, you have stopped yourself. You have stopped everyone. And that must never happen in this country. It must never happen in this country. Because if it does, there'll never be another congregation like this, and you'll never hear me speak again, because I'll be dead. And so will most of you. This country is about freedom. Because only with freedom can you have all of the other things that everybody professes that they want. It's the only way it can be done. I hear all kinds of misconceptions and misstatements. I have the freedom of the press. No, you don't. No, you don't. The man who owns the press has the freedom of the press. And he can say in his press whatever he wants, but you can't. That's why I get angry with Americans when they say, the Jews control the press. Who sold it to them? How'd they get it? You want the press? Start a press. You want to be on the radio? Do it. But stop whining. Stop bitching. Stop complaining. That guy that owns the press, that's his press. He can do with it what he wants. Just like you do with your car what you want because it's your property. He doesn't owe you anything unless you've got a contract with his signature on it that says he will print what you say. If you can't produce that, he doesn't owe you anything. That's America. You know what's wonderful about America? You can have a press. I have a press. How many of you have seen my newspaper? That newspaper is no joke. It makes congressmen cringe when they see it. It scares the hell out of the enemy. You too can have a radio show. I'm going to teach you how just here in just a couple of minutes. You too can publish books like this. I did it. The Harvest Trust is the trust for my children. I'm not rich. I don't have anything. You know how I financed this book? I sold copies before it was printed to people who believed enough in me to buy them. I don't have any money. I have my family. And that's all the wealth I ever need. I don't make any money from my radio show. Veritas has operated in the red from the beginning. And probably always will. But I got something that you don't have. I have a free press. It's mine. And I get to say what I want. And I get to publish what I want and print what I want because it's mine. And I'm free. And it's my free press. That's why I don't care if somebody calls up my radio show and says they don't like what I say. Screw you, get your own show. I don't care that they complain because I won't let them talk on my radio show. Screw you. Get your own radio show. This is mine. Belongs to me. I don't have any contract with you. I don't owe you anything. I was speaking in California one time. A lady stood up in the middle of the crowd and said, "You make me so angry. You're a terrible man. Why didn't you tell me this years ago?" She was lucky I was telling her then. I didn't owe her anything. But she blamed me because she didn't have the information that I was imparting to her on that day years ago. And I had it years before that. I didn't know how to do it. I would have. Oh God, I would have. You don't really understand sometimes what a terrible burden it is to know some of the things that I know and try to wake people up and impart this knowledge to them and find out that they just have walls built in front of them. They want to be slaves. But we're making some chinks in those walls. You too can have a free press, and that's what it's going to take to get this country back without bloodshed. And I'm going to tell you right now, unless we can be successful in creating a real free press where the American people get different viewpoints other than those expressed in the establishment-controlled media, there's going to be a civil war in this country, and it's going to come soon. The only thing that can stop it is by waking up vast amounts of sleeping people. Sheeple is what they are. They are following the Judas goat right into the shearing pens, and from there they will go to the slaughter, and they will not know that anything is wrong until they smell the blood of the sheeple in front of them. Anybody can publish a newsletter or a newspaper. Anybody. It is not expensive. It is not difficult. And everyone in this room should be doing it all across this country. And everybody that you come in contact with, you should encourage them to do it. And we should flood this nation with information. Not rumor, not opinion, not bullshit. Documented fact. Everything you print must be documented. If it's not, eventually people will stop reading your newsletter or your newspaper. Because all they have to do is check out a few things and find out it's not true and you're finished. You must publish only documented fact. And you must stay away from printing articles from people who will not document as fact what they put in their articles. That's why my broadcast scares the hell out of socialists. That's why in a White House memorandum, I was named as the most dangerous radio host in America, not because I'm going to go out and shoot somebody, but because I shoot documented facts, which cannot be refuted. That's why. That's what's dangerous. Seek ye the truth, and the truth will make you free, and nothing else will do it. Jesus Christ has never lied to anybody. Why won't you listen to him? Don't spread a rumor. Spread the truth. Document it. Prove it. Make it irrefutable, and you too will become dangerous to those who admire us in lies and enslave us in socialism. Anytime any system makes you dependent upon anybody or anything or any system, you are enslaved. Understand that. Doesn't have to be chains of iron. You don't have to be hanging up on a wall. You just have to be obligated. That's all it takes. You too can have your own radio station and broadcast anything that you want. You can broadcast your own shows. You can be your own host on that show. You can broadcast tapes of other shows. We encourage people to buy satellite receiving stations across this country, purchase a very simple FM low-power transmitting kit, and set up their own FM radio station in their hometown. And we now have over 670 people across the nation. It's not expensive. If one person cannot afford the cost, what is wrong with 8 or 10 or 15 or 20 of you getting together, pooling your money, buying one satellite receiving station, a small FM low power transmitter, and setting up your own broadcasting station.